Hey everybody, this is Nick. I got a great viewer question from Jason on one of our videos about how to stop that auto-shrinking property inside of default text boxes inside of PowerPoint. And his question was, is there any way to apply changes to 60 plus slides with multiple text boxes, or would it be better for me to give up on my career and live off the grid? Jason, don't give up your career. I don't know of any magical button that's going to reformat all 60 of those slides with the text boxes, but there's a few text box shortcuts that I think might help you out on this. So the first one is going to be this. We all know that we can do Control C and Control V to copy and paste an object, but you can do the same thing with formatting if you use Shift Control C and Shift Control V. So the thing that you want to do is make sure that your text box is, your first text box is set up perfectly. This is the one that you want to copy your formatting over to all the other ones. So I'm going to make sure that this is going to be, let's say, 18-point font, Aptos family, and I'm going to go over to the properties and make sure that my shrink text on autoflow is selected off, because I don't want that property on mine. It already is resize shape to fit text. That's perfect. So I'm going to go ahead over here to the text box, make sure that the entire text box is highlighted and selected. I'm going to go ahead and push on my keyboard, Shift Control C. And now I'm going to click over here to another text box, make sure the whole text box is highlighted. Sometimes I have to double click it to make sure the whole text box is actually selected. And now I'm going to push Shift Control and V. And there we go. It's taking the exact same properties. I can go ahead and do that again, Shift Control V. Because just like copy and paste, the formatting now lives behind the scenes on the clipboard and it's still activated. So anything that I click now and push Shift Control V, it's going to take that exact same property of the one that I copied originally. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So that is method number one. That's a shortcut number one. It involves some clicking, but maybe it's not the end of the world. The next one, I really like this one, and this is using the Format Painter. So have you ever used the Format Painter to format objects or text? This is the way to do that. So again, you wanna set up your text box. I'm gonna make sure that this one is set properly on the timing. Yep, resize shape to fit text, that's what I want. I'm gonna go ahead and click this. I'm gonna go up to the Format Painter. It's that little paintbrush icon on the clipboard icon on the Home tab. Go ahead and click it. When you click it, you know it's activated because the little paintbrush icon is right next to your cursor there. Now, anything that I click will take the property of what I just painted. So I'm gonna go ahead and paint that. Perfect. Now, the one thing is you have to go back up and click again to repaint the next object. But the cool thing is you can keep the paintbrush, the format painter activated if you double click the paintbrush. So let's go ahead, let's click on this. This is what I want to format copy or copy the format of. Go up to the paintbrush icon, double click, and now you can see that the little paintbrush icon is activated. Now all I have to do is click and it's still activated. Click on this text box, click on the next one, and it takes the properties of everything. Now this works across slides too, because when I click on to the next slide, you can see that I have another text box, but the paintbrush is still activated, and I could go ahead and do that. So it works across slides, so you can go ahead and click through all 60 of your slides and just keep on clicking all the text boxes. That is my favorite trick right there. Now, to undo or to deactivate the Format Painter, just go back up to the paintbrush and click it one time, and now you're deactivated. Now I'm gonna click undo here, because my third tip right here, this might not help you, but I wanted to share with everybody that you can set the default text box property to any of your PowerPoint decks. And this is for any text box that you would insert manually that don't come from text box placeholders that were from master slide layouts. So right here, I have this text right here. It's set to Franklin Gothic Medium Condensed. It's 20 points. Let's just go ahead and color it green. Let's just say I want all of my text to be green that I insert into my deck. All you have to do here is right click and go down to Set as Default Text Box. I'm gonna click that. Now, any text box that I manually insert into my deck will take these exact same properties. So let's go ahead and click insert text box right here. I'm gonna insert this text box right here. I'm gonna type equals lorem open parenthesis and close parenthesis for some placeholder text, push enter, and there we go. It's the exact same properties as that. So that would help if you wanted to start your deck from scratch and you always wanted the same custom formatting to each of those manually inserted text boxes. Now the very last thing, this involves some PowerPoint, little PowerPoint know-how behind the scenes. If your PowerPoint deck that you have of 60 plus slides is using text boxes that all come from master slide layouts, from the stock layouts that PowerPoint provides you, all you might have to do is work with that slide master to make some tweaks to the text placeholder here, and then it would copy to the rest of your deck. So here is one of those stock layouts. You've probably seen this one before. If you go up to the layout tab, the layout menu right here on the home tab, it shows you all the different default layouts, the slide layouts that PowerPoint might give you. It gives you that placeholder for a title and a placeholder for text or content. And so you can see right here, this one is activated. So this is my two content slide. So it has a header and two pieces of content. Let's go ahead and just insert a new slide here. Let's go ahead and insert the title and content just one. So now we just have one big text box and one big title box. Now, if I had some text in here, let's just go ahead and type some placeholder text, slide title, and then let's go ahead here and do that lorem ipsum trick again, and we'll do that. I'm gonna do that, and I'm also gonna do that on the next slide here. And let's go ahead and type this. Okay, so now I have some placeholder text here on each of these slides. When I go to the View tab, and then we go to the Slide Master tab, this gives us a peek under the hood. So if I scroll right here, you can see this slide is activated. That's because the slide that I just came from in normal view was that content, the two content slide layout. But if I scroll all the way up, you'll see right here, this little parent slide here. This is called the Slide Master, and underneath that parent slide, we have lots of different child layouts. Anything that I add to or reformat to this slide master, this slide right here, the parent slide, will take all of the child, will give those properties to all of the child layouts too. So if I change the header here, it's going to change the header on this one and this one and this one and all the different slide layouts that come from that. If I change the text here, reformat the text, it's going to do the same thing. So let's go ahead on the slide master here, and I'm going to go ahead and reformat this. I'm going to make sure I want it to be, let's see, let's make it be 54 points. I want it to be blue, and I want it to be bold. So I want all the headers, the title text across all of my slide layouts to be bold and blue. And then this one right here for the content, I'm going to actually go over to the properties text box right here. Right now it's defaulted to shrink text on overflow. Remember, we don't want that. So I'm going to go ahead and say resize shape. The other one we could do is do not auto fit, but I'm just going to go ahead and click on resize shape to fit text. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to increase the font size just a little bit to 20. Point font. And then just for good measure, let's go ahead and change this to red. Okay. So now everything that I have, every slide that I have in normal view that pulls from any of these slide layouts should have those changes applied to it. There could be this little button right here that you get that says apply to all. I would go ahead and click it. Perfect. We're going to go back to the View tab. I'm going to go to the normal view. And now you can see these two slides that came from that came from those child slide layouts now take the properties of the text that I just added into the master slide. If you wanted to reset this slide, all you have to do is click on the reset tab right there. And the thing is, nothing happened because it's all perfect. But if I were to go ahead and change something on the slide, let's change this title text to green and make it really large. And then let's change this text to blue, and then I go back to the reset tab. That's going to reset everything to those properties. And then another way to know if this text came from a placeholder is just to simply delete it. And then you can see that the placeholder goes back into place right there. It shows you where that placeholder is supposed to be. So if for some reason you had a whole bunch of text boxes on your slides that were from those text placeholders, you could go up to that master slide and change, reformat all the text there to the content and the title, and then that would apply to all of your other slides. So that's a little bit more of an advanced trick. And you can see that none of the changes happen on these slides, but that's because what I used for these slides is the blank layout. So there's no placeholders included on these slides that I used for those extra test ones. So go ahead, Jason, try some of these tricks out. Remember, you can copy and paste formatting with Shift Control C and Shift Control V. Go ahead and try that number one. the format painter, make sure to double click it to keep it activated, and then click across slides and across text boxes to reformat those from the first one that you set up. I like that trick the best. Remember, set your default text box style when you're setting up a PowerPoint template in the future if that's going to be helpful for you. And then if everything comes from one of those content placeholders or the text placeholders, you might be able to work with the slide master to make changes and have them apply across your deck. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. I hope it's helpful. Let me know in the comments. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. And don't forget to join my channel. It's $1.99 a month, and you get priority access to these viewer question videos and also instant access to my videos as I post them. Otherwise, you gotta wait one time per week. I hope you all had a great time watching. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.